Hey guys, welcome once again. Well, electric vehicle is being a very trending topic nowadays. Don't worry, I'm not going to babble what others have done so far. I just want to clear out some basic confusions and myths related to charging of electric vehicles. In today's video, we'll see how the electric vehicle's charging work. If you bought or planning to buy an electric vehicle, I would highly recommend to check out this video to understand some terms related to EV charging, such as what is meant by the capacity of battery, why do EVs take so much time to charge at home, what are the onboard and offboard chargers, what is the DC fast charging, what is an EVSE or wall mount charger, what is the charging socket, how does the charger works, and what are the safety features for charging in the EV? Well, that's a lot to learn. See, to give you a small summary of electric vehicles, every electric vehicle works on the battery. In order to use your vehicle, you need to charge the batteries first. That's the thumb rule, right? Before you jump for the charging, we need to understand battery specifications. Well, these days, we are using lithium-ion batteries which have a higher energy density. The energy density is basically the amount of energy stored in a particular space or system in a given volume. The lithium-ion batteries have an energy density of 250 Wh per kg. Wh is the unit of energy, which is in electrical terms, power measured in watts into time in hours. I'll not go much deeper into details, but to understand this, you should have basic understanding of energy density. The battery's capacity is measured in watt hours, which is voltage into ampere hour. If you have seen the electric vehicle battery's specification, it is given in kilowatt hour. Kilo means the thousand. As the battery pack of the EVs are huge, watt hour is very small unit to measure. For example, the Hyundai Kona has battery pack of 39.2 kilowatt hour. Well, to charge it fully, we need to fill the same amount of energy into battery pack, right? As simple as that. Hence, to do so, we use the chargers. The specifications of the chargers come into kilowatt, which is a unit of power. And as we said, the energy is power into time. The charger charges the battery according to its power handling capacity. If the battery's capacity is of 39.2 kilowatt hour and we charge it in the house with small 3.3 kilowatt charger, then it will take more than 12 hours to charge the batteries. And if we use a bigger 10 kilowatt charger, then it will take roughly only 4 hours to charge. And if you use a 100 kilowatt DC fast charger to charge these batteries, then ideally it will take less than 30 minutes to charge these batteries. Well, it doesn't charge that quickly due to limitation of battery chemistry, but you got the concept, right? So it is very favorable to charge EV batteries with the DC fast charger to save time. As we increase battery capacity, the power requirements also increase to charge these huge batteries. With that being said, there are two types of chargers. First is the onboard charger and second is the offboard charger. In easier terms, we'll categorize them as AC charger and DC charger. The onboard chargers are present in the vehicle itself, where you can give AC supply coming from the grid and charge the batteries directly. But still, you cannot just insert two wires of line and neutral coming from the grid and connect it to the vehicle. For that, you need a device in between named EVSE, that is electric vehicle supply equipment. Some people call it as wall mount charger, which comes with the vehicle itself or can be bought separately. This piece of box is connected between the vehicle and the grid. Next is the offboard charger, which is present outside the vehicle. It is generally the DC type charger. It contains very high power. It actually converts AC into DC on its own and DC power is given to the vehicle through its inlet. This time, the power is directly provided to the battery pack. The outboard chargers are basically very powerful than AC chargers. But with great power comes greater size. So the size and cost of the outboard charger are very much as compared to wall mount AC chargers. Well, there is a dedicated connector present at the outlet of the charger which goes into vehicle's inlet. This connector ensures whether the vehicle is connected properly or not and provides the information required for charging. These connectors are different for both AC and DC chargers. These connectors are fully waterproof, which comes with IP certification. In AC charger, there are two types of supplies, which are single phase and three phase. This input directly goes to the EVSE, and at the output of the charger, these supply cables are extended, but there is a contactor or relay in between to ensure isolation and safety between output and input. And there is one more wire coming out of the connector named control pilot, which is present for the communication between charger and EVSE. You know, without any communication, how will the charger know whether the input is applied or not? This signal gives the information such as the vehicle is connected to the EVSE, the vehicle is ready for the charging, and charging is taking place. One more important function of the pilot signal is to provide the current capacity of the input supply to the vehicle. Well, to give you an example of working, the EVSE sends a signal to the vehicle such as, dude, only 15 amperes current is available on this side. And vehicle be like, really? Then I need to program myself according to 15 amperes only? And the charger programs the charging logic on that basis. Cool, isn't it? And if any fault occurs in the charging from either side, the EVSE detects and disconnects the vehicle from the supply for safety. One more important feature of the EVSE is there is no supply at the output of the socket until and unless an EV is connected to it. The supply will be live only when the EV is connected. So don't get confused and don't believe in the myths that if we accidentally touch the socket of the connectors, then you'll get fried due to shock. No, it's not possible. However, there is a limitation for AC charging. We cannot go more than certain power limits in AC charging due to limitation of onboard chargers present in the vehicle. In short, these chargers can't handle high powers due to their size constraints in the vehicle. So the charger size should be reduced. That's why we move to the outboard chargers. On the outboard chargers, which are DC type, has a DC power, which gives regulated output of the combination of continuous current charging and continuous voltage charging according to need of the battery. But for that, the vehicle should be compatible with DC fast charging. Out of all vehicles present in the market, mostly four-wheelers or the commercial vehicles and buses support DC charging because they have very large battery pack. And they take very long time if we charge using AC charging. On the two-wheeler side, we have smaller batteries, so the power coming from AC is sufficient to charge these batteries. In this case of DC charger, the charger communicates with the battery management system of the vehicle. This system commands to the charger and provides the information regarding the health of the battery and its state of charge. The state of charge can be displayed on the screen fixed on the charger, and we get the information how much a vehicle is charged. The last part is related to billing. The cost depends on how much power you have used over the time period, and based on that, the calculations are done. The type of charger also plays a significant role in the billing. Well, that was all related to EV charging infrastructure. I hope some doubts are clear. If you still have any question, you can ask down in the comment section. Hit the like button if you liked the video. Subscribe to my channel. And finally, thanks for watching.